Continuing with that, now we will take an example problem and see how this Bayes theorem works. Okay? So, example. Now, I have patients, the data of patients, which there are two categories of patients. Patients having a particular form of cancer and patients which do not have a particular form of cancer. Okay? So, two outcomes it will have. One is called as a positive outcome. Positive means they have the cancer represented like this, and the second one will be negative outcome. This I represent like this, that means they don't have cancer. Now what is given to you? We have prior knowledge that over the entire population of people, only 0.08 have this disease. So the prior knowledge is only 0.08 people have the disease. Okay? Then what else is given? Then, okay, the lab test he says is an imperfect indicator of the disease. Means it is not an exact indicator of the disease, the lab test. Like how we have corona, so many times you take rapid antigen test. It can be negative when it is actually positive. So people don't rely on a rapid antigen. They ask you to take a swab test, right? So it is not a perfect indicator. The lab test is an imperfect indicator of the disease. Now, the test returns correct positive result in only 98% of the cases. So if you take a test also, it returns a correct positive result in 98% of the cases and correct negative result in 97% of the cases. Correct negative result. Negative result means disease is not present. Disease not present in 97% of the cases. Okay? In other cases, it will return the opposite result. That means if it is a positive result, it will show it as negative. Okay? And the vice versa. Now, what we have to do? We now observe a new patient for which the lab test returns a positive result. Okay? Should we diagnose the patient as having cancer or not? Now, a new patient has come in. According to lab test, it shows it is a positive result. Now, according based on that, can we diagnose whether the patient is having cancer or not? Okay, so we have to find the maximum posteriori hypothesis here for both having cancer and not having cancer. Whichever value is higher, that becomes the outcome of the exam. Okay, so first you can write what is given to you. Now, the probability of people having cancer is equal to, he says, 0.08. Okay, so probability of people not having cancer, this is a non symbol, not having cancer is 1 minus 0.08, which is 0.02. Okay, then what is given? Probability of the test result correctly giving a positive result, that is correctly showing he has cancer, is 98% of the time. So it is 0.98. Then if it is, this is correct, then what is the probability of showing a negative result? When he actually has a positive result, it is 0.02. Oh, this is not 0.02, this is 0.99, 1 minus 0.08. Okay? Then, third one, probability of correctly showing a negative result. How much is it? 97% of the time. Okay? Now, probability of incorrectly showing a negative result. This is a negative result. This is not having cancer. Okay? So, probability of incorrectly showing a negative result is equal to, correctly showing a negative result means he is not having cancer and he is showing as negative. Correct? That is 0.97. Here he is not having cancer but it is showing as positive. That is the reverse, that is 0.02. Okay? This much of data is given to you. Now, first what we will do, we will find out what is H max. both probability of a patient having cancer positive case. If you apply the formula, it is probability of D given H into probability of H. So H is probability of cancer. This is a true case. Same thing for the negative case, it is probability of is it showing a positive result but not having cancer into probability of cancer. These are the two cases here. One is he is having cancer and is showing a positive result. Okay. Another one is he is not having cancer and is showing a the result is a true result. This indicates that the result is a correct result. Okay. So I am going to check both the cases. Whichever his value is higher, that will be the output of the patient who has come in. Okay, where the lab result shows a positive result. So this will be how much is what is this value? Probability of having cancer and showing a positive result. It is 0.98. And the probability of having cancer is 0.08. So the output will be 0.0078. Okay. The second case, probability of not having cancer and is showing a positive result. That is 0.03 into probability of not having cancer is 0.992. This is equal to 0.0298. Okay. So when we compare the two values, this has a higher probability not having cancer. That indicates that the patient who has come in with the lab test showing a positive result actually does not have cancer. Okay? So this is a simple example of your Bayes theory, where you have applied the maximum posteriori hypothesis. We have to diagnose the patient as having cancer or not. Okay, I hope this is clear.